this is just an update video to let you guys know about the hardware changes which I made in this new version. It is still not complete, but I wanted to let you know about the hardware changes because some of you guys were asking for sketches for the older version and you wanted to make it. So I thought I should update you so you don't order any extra parts. So first of all, you can see that I have removed the OLED display and the keypad, and their functions are replaced by this Esp8266 based board. It communicates with the Arduino Nano board over serial, and it can receive settings values, time, and it can also send new settings to Arduino Nano using this web page, which I made using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. I'm still a beginner in all these three things, so it might not look very pretty, but that was not my priority. It will be sometime in the future, but not now. The main functions, which are to get the settings from Nano, get the sensor values and the time, and show them on the web page without reloading the whole page, works. You can see that the time is changing and the whole page is not reloaded. It is done using JavaScript and AJAX requests. Every 10 seconds, Arduino Nano sends all these values, and the browser is running JavaScript code and it requests new values, and if it gets new values, it updates that specific section of the web page. Beside these settings, you can also see the states of switches and different errors from the ESP itself and Arduino Nano. The other changes which I am going to make is with the sensors. I found this cheap 555 timer based capacitive moisture sensor. It gives out analog voltage signal just like these resistive sensors. They are just here because I wanted to test everything, but they will be replaced by sensors like this soil moisture sensor, which is a capacitive soil moisture sensor. Everything else is almost the same. I have added a transistor to turn these water sensors on and off whenever they are needed. For example, at watering time, these sensors will turn on, and if the water reservoir is empty, these sensors will turn on after a minute or two. You can set it in the sketch to check if someone has refilled the reservoir. This water level sensor and this capacitive sensor are connected directly to 5 volts power supply because I added them afterwards. But these two sensors are connected to the transistor. Can see that they are currently off. So let me just show you how you can change the settings. So to change the settings, there are these change buttons. to change the time, there is a separate button. If I click on this button, you can see that input fields have appeared and you can enter new settings here and then click on the save button. So I'll just to show you that it works, I'll change the time and move the hour 1 hour ahead from the current time. I wanted to show the current time that is received from the Nano in these input fields, so it is easier to change the settings. But I have already mentioned that it's not complete. So it will happen once I complete it. So I have entered the settings. When I click on save, these settings will go to the ESP and then ESP will send them over serial to Arduino Nano. If Arduino Nano receives some valid settings, it will blink this blue LED 5 times rapidly to indicate that it has received some valid settings. Then it will send these settings immediately back to ESP for verification, and ESP will match them with the settings it had received previously from the browser. If those settings match, it will send a save instruction to Arduino. Then Arduino will verify the settings again itself, and if everything is fine, it will save these settings. In case of time, it will save these settings to the RTC, and in case of other settings, it will save them to the internal EEPROM. And to indicate that the settings have been saved, it will blink this light with slightly longer delays. So let's click on the save button. So it received the settings immediately when I clicked on the save button. It verified them and it saved them also. It happens quickly, so you can see them when you are doing it yourself. The settings are saved. This alert is shown by the browser, and it happens only when the ESP has sent those settings to Arduino Nano. And it happened almost immediately when I clicked on save. Now I click on OK and go to the home page. You can see that the time has changed. If I reload the page manually, you can see for a brief period of time that values are not shown, instead some dashes are shown instead of numbers. That will happen if there are no settings or time values received from the Nano board. And after a certain period of time, it will also show an alert in the browser if no time values are received or no sensor values are received, or if there is another settings values error or something else, it will show an alert. But it is receiving new values and it is showing them on the web page itself. Now same thing happens If you want to change the settings, click on the change button. Input fields are shown. You can enter settings here. Click on save and it will save. Now there is some verification going on in the browser itself by JavaScript. If you click on save without entering any settings, it will show you this alert. With the normal value ranges which are acceptable. For example, this water R should be from 0 to 23. If you enter 24, it will still give you an error. Because all the settings are empty, it is showing that all of the settings in the alert. But if only one setting is wrong, it will show only that. There is HTML5 verification, but it stopped working after I changed some things in the browser part, in the web page part. But the JavaScript always works in every browser, and there are also checks for correct values of time and settings in the Arduino Nano itself. It will not save any settings if they are wrong. The same kind of verification which happens in the JavaScript also happens in the Arduino Nano. Just keep in mind that it's not complete, so there are some bugs in the web page, but they are only related to the behavior of the web page. The main thing, which is to monitor the settings, the time, the sensor values, and to change the time and settings, they work. Now I want to move all the water sensors and the relays used to turn on the pumps or solenoids to another nano board and connect that nano board with the main board inside this box over I2C using two wires. This new nano board will act as a sleeve to this first nano board. I want it to be expandable so we can add more sensors and more water control things. And maybe I'll move the lights, the fans, and the temperature control things to new nano boards to make everything expandable. I wanted to do the same thing with the ESP and Nano. I wanted them to communicate over I2C, but there are some issues with the ESP. It can support I2C in master and slave mode, but currently there is only master support. But I wanted the Nano to be independent of ESP, and it has to take time from the RTC over I2C, so it has to be the master. So if I remove the ESP right now, it will still work. Everything will work without the ESP. This is what I want. But the water part must be expandable, because there are not enough pins and you have to wire everything from the plants and from the pumps to the main board. So it should be expandable. So this is just a progress update. Again, it's not complete. When it is complete, I'll post another video. So please like and subscribe, comment. Bye.